Construction of the Trans Mountain Expansion Project involves crossing streams, creeks, and rivers along the route. Each water crossing on the project is studied in detail, and a site-specific watercourse crossing plan is developed based on the specific features, plants, and wildlife at the crossing. Before construction begins, environmental mitigation work takes place to ensure potential impacts to plants, fish, and wildlife will be minimized as much as possible. Work begins by preparing the site for the arrival of construction equipment and pipe sections. This includes clearing and topsoil stripping and storage. The pipe sections that are to be installed in the waterbed are welded together, and these welds are tested and coated prior to installation. Once the site is ready, construction begins by isolating the work area. For the dam and pump isolation technique, a pump is used to move clean water through a hose around the work area and downstream onto a secured scour blanket, which prevents erosion and sedimentation of the watercourse. A backup pump and pump hose are set up in case of malfunction. This saves time and maintains care and control of the in-stream work. Before removing water from the isolated section of a fish-bearing watercourse, fish are moved downstream. Once the dam is in place and the watercourse bed is dry, the surface stream bed is removed and stockpiled for later replacement. A trench is then dug, and the prepared pipe section is lowered into the trench and capped off. The trench is backfilled, and any standing water in the trench is pumped out to prevent sediment-heavy water returning to the watercourse. The stream bed surface material is replaced, and bank reclamation begins to ensure the bed and bank are appropriately tied together prior to removing the dams. The stream bank is recontoured to match its original configuration. The pumps and the dam are removed, starting from the downstream end. The upstream dam is slowly removed to avoid swift flowing water damaging the stream bed. The watercourse and crossing site will be reclaimed to its original condition, with consideration made to protect the bank by installing erosion control systems, such as cocoa matting. The site is revegetated with seedlings, native seeds, and any salvaged shrubs. Water quality monitoring takes place throughout construction. In addition, post-construction monitoring takes place for 5 years following construction to validate the area has been reclaimed to a state equal or better than it was in prior to construction. All activities are carried out in accordance with permit conditions and are inspected by multiple regulators, including the Canada Energy Regulator. Expanding the Trans Mountain Pipeline System will increase Canada's capacity to get our resources to market and generate lasting economic benefits. Throughout construction, we'll provide timely and transparent updates on our progress and activities.